Suppose on your first trip to supermarket, you purchased 3 apples and your overall expense was $6. On your second trip, you purchased 5 apples and it costed you $8. Note that the total expense also includes parking charges, which are the same in both cases. Now, if you have to go to the supermarket to buy 10 apples, how much will it cost you? Before going further, please think for a moment and try to solve this. Now, to solve this question, let's convert these equations to a simpler form. To begin with, I want to stick to a standard formulation of such a problem. We can simply say expense is equal to parking charges plus cost of apple multiplied with number of apples. Or we can say in the general formal notation, y is equal to beta 0 plus beta 1 multiplied with x. Now let's fill in the values. For the first trip, the equation is 3 multiplied with beta 1 plus beta 0 equals 6. And for your second trip, the equation is 5 multiplied with beta 1 plus beta 0 equals 8. Now, can you solve these equations for beta 0 and beta 1? Think for a moment before proceeding further. Let's solve it. So if you subtract the first equation from the second equation, you can calculate the value of beta. So the value of beta 1 comes as 1. Now if you take this value of beta 1 and substitute it in equation number 1, you can compute beta 0, which comes as 3. So the final equation is y equals 3 plus 1 multiplied with x. Now you can answer the question about the expenses for 10 apples by simply putting 10 in the place of x in the final equation by solving it for y. So y value comes as 13. That means you need to carry $13 with you for buying 10 apples. You can also represent it and solve it using a graph where the y-axis represents expenses and x-axis represents apples. As the parking charges are fixed, we don't need to keep it on any axis. The question states the expenses for buying 3 apples is $6. So as the number of apples is 3, the value on the x-axis will be 3. And as the expenses are 6, the y value will be 6. In the same way, we can represent another coordinate, which is 5,8. Now let's draw a line passing through these coordinates. So this line is the model that we are looking for. Now we can find the expenses for buying any number of apples using this line. We just need to project the mentioned x coordinate on the line and find its corresponding y value. So let's find the expenses for buying 10 apples. It comes out as $13. Very simple, right? The main idea was to give you an overview of the symbols we are going to use. So we figured out the model. The model is basically the line that's going through the data points. And once we have the model, we can quickly predict the outcomes for unseen values. Now let's level up the game. What if we had three variables in the equation? Imagine that we are buying apples and mangoes this time, and there is a parking charge on every trip. So, one apple and one mango costs you $35. Three apple and two mangoes costs you $75. And four apples and three mangoes, $105. Now, find out what will be the expenses for buying five apples and five mangoes. Before going further, please take some time to solve this. The approach to solving these three variable equations is to reduce these equations into two variables and then reduce the two equations into one equation and then solve it. Let's rewrite these equations first. And then we subtract the first equation from the second equation. So we get 2a plus 1m equals 40. Now let's subtract the second equation from the third. By doing that, we get 1a plus 1m equals 30. Now let's subtract the second equation from the first. On doing that, m gets eliminated and we get the value of a as $10. Now with this, we can find the value of m by substituting it in any of the two variable equations. So the value of m comes as $20. Now putting it back in the first equation, we can find the parking charge, which comes as $5. Now, once we know these three values, we can answer all the combinations of apples, mangoes, and parking. So the expense for buying five apples and five mangoes, including the parking charges, is $155. Let's see how we can solve this using the graph system. It is the same as previous one. Apart from that, it is a three-variable linear equation. Hence, we need three axes to represent it. So, we'll represent the number of apples by x-axis, the number of mangoes by y-axis, and the expenses by z-axis. As our first equation states, for buying one apple and one mango, the expense is 35. So our first coordinate becomes 1, 1, 35. In the same way, we can plot the coordinates for the other two equations, which are 3, 2, 75 and 4, 3, 105. Let's plot our model, which is a line passing through these points. As our model is ready, we can find the expense for buying any number of apples and mangoes. I'm sure most of the people would have no difficulty in following along so far. Actually, we can solve the consecutive equations of any number of variables by following the same process as long as equations are unique. For example, we cannot find values of a, m, and p from these three equations. This is because if we divide the second equation by 3 and the third equation by 2, these all three become the same equation. And we need three different equations to solve a three-variable equation. Hence, we cannot solve these three equations. In this video, we learned about prediction and how it opens a whole new domain of machine learning. We also saw how to solve two-variable and three-variable equations using elimination and graphical methods. We basically did prediction using two data points and three data points. Using the concepts you learned today, try solving these equations displayed on the screen and post your answer in comments. That's all for this video. In the next video, we will see how to code all these concepts from scratch using Python.